So the problem is like this. Determine, again, second problem, determine the reactions RA and RB. We have to find the reactions. Shear force at C, bending moment at C, and maximum bending moment, okay, using the influence line diagram, using the ILD for the given for the beam shown below. Right, I will draw the beam. This is your simply supported beam with RA and RB, and you have a load of 50 kilonewton now here at a distance of 3 meters, and the total span of the beam is 10 meters. Right? So for this numerical, we have to draw the by the influence line diagram, we have to get the values of RA and RB. Right? What is the first step? We have to consider unit load. Right? So your diagram becomes like this now. When I consider a unit load, this is your RA, this is your RB, and here I'm considering a unit load at a distance X, not at 3, at a distance X, and the span will remain 10 only, 10 meters. Correct? From here, I have to find the values of RA and RB. So to say, I want to get the value of RA first, so ILD for RA when I'm doing. So where do I take moment? Moment at B equal to 0. Quickly tell me the equation for moment at B equal to 0 in this beam. If I'm taking moment at B equal to 0, what is the equation you get? I'm taking moment at this point 0. What is the equation you get? Hello?
RA into 10.
Answer.
RA into 10.
Yes. RA into 10 minus?
Minus 10 into X.
10 ala. 1 into? I'm taking moment at B equal to 0. So RA into 10 minus 1 into 10 minus X.
10 minus.
So this 10 minus X is equal to 0. From here, RA into 10 will be equal to 10 minus X, or RA value is what? 10 minus X by 10. Correct? So X value here, I have 3 values. Once X is 0, then X is equal to 3, and when X equal to 10. Correct? From the diagram, when X is equal to 0, then X is equal to 3, and when X is equal to 10. These are my 3 values. So substitute here. What happens to RA when X is equal to 0? 10 minus 0 is 10. 10 divided by 10 is 1. When X is equal to 3, 10 minus 3 is 7. 7 divided by 10 is 0.7. Correct? And then when X equal to 10, 10 minus 10 is 0. So this becomes 0. So what about the ILD for RA? What happens to ILD for RA? Right? At X equal to 0, the RA value is 1. At X equal to 3, the RA value is 0.7. And at X equal to 0, sorry, X equal to 10, this is X equal to 3 and X equal to 0, the RA value is 0. So it becomes like this. This is the influence line diagram for reaction RA. Right? So once you get this, we have to get the value of RA. Therefore, magnitude of RA will be obtained by what? Formula is load into ILD value at ordinate. So load, external load is 50 kilonewton. ILD ordinate is 0.7. What is this value now? 35 kilonewtons. So RA is now 35 kilonewton. Okay. So we got a value of RA as 35 kilonewton. Same thing, we have to, by the same method, I have to get now for RB, right? So where will I take moment if I want to find RB? So ILD for RB, when I'm doing, I will take moment at A equal to 0. to get RB, I have to take moment at this point equal to 0. So what is the equation? RB into 10 with anti-clockwise. So minus RB into 10, then 1 into X, that is plus 1 into X is equal to 0. So how, from here, what is the condition for RB? RB will be equal to X divided by 10. Correct? 10 goes at the bottom. RB comes this side. So here, again, I'll have at X equal to 0, at X equal to 3, and at X equal to 10. I have to solve. So when X equal to 0, 0 by 10 is 0. At X equal to 3, 3 divided by 10 makes it 0.3. And at X equal to 10, this becomes 1. Right? So when I draw this diagram, right, this is X equal to 0, this is X equal to 3, and this is X equal to 10. So at X equal to 0, your value is 0. At X equal to 3, the value is 0.3. And at X equal to 10, the value is 1. Like this. Okay. My video has stopped, is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Just be on the line for 1 minute. That app has automatically stopped. If you all are solving anybody, please solve. Let's see. Have to restart. It will take 1 minute. Visible now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So X equal to 0, value was 0. At X equal to 3, I got an ordinate value of 0.3. And at X equal to 10, I got a value of 1. Correct? So you draw this diagram. Remember, this will be going into negative. Okay? We have seen previously. I will doing the shear force again, I will show. So once this is plotted, this is the influence line diagram for RB. Okay, the influence line diagram for RB, and now based on this, if I want to get the value of RB, it is going to be load into the value of ordinate 0.3. What is this value, please?
15.
15.
Yes, so the value of RB is 15 kilo newtons. We know to get these reaction values using summation f of x, summation f of y. And now we are getting the same reaction values using the influence line diagrams. Okay. So these are the reaction values. After this, we have to calculate the shear force. Right? Next, going to the shear force diagram. So it is IID for shear force at C. I'm most interested in C. So I will just draw that previous diagram now. So when I drew the influence line diagram for RA, I had a unit value here and I had a value of 0 at this junction. Correct? Okay. I had a unit value here. I had a 0 at this junction. And my ordinate at point C was how much? 0.7. It was like this. Okay, and when we are drawing influence line diagram for RB here it becomes 1 and at this junction it is 0.3 and this will be 0 and this is how your influence line diagram is. So when I'm drawing the shear force diagram, it is important you show this is 1. At this point also it is 1, but it is now divided into 0.7 of positive and 0.3 of negative. And here it is negative 1. Okay. So this ILD diagram, this is ILD for shear force at C. Okay. This is very important. ILD for shear force. This is both combination of RA and combination of RB. This is now based on this, when we calculate further. So shear force at C, when we are calculating, formula is what? It is load into the ordinates in IID. Now there are two ordinate, one is 0.7 and one is 0.3. So I have to make use of both. So load is 50 into one ordinate is 0.7, which is positive, plus again load is 50, one ordinate is negative, that is 0.3. So 50 into 0.7 plus 50 into minus 0.3. What is the value? What is this value?
20.
Correct. 20 kilonewton is your shear force value at point C. Okay. Now, based on this, if I want to calculate the maximum shear force, which is positive, is going to be what? It is going to be 50 into 0.7. How much is this? 35 kilonewton. Correct. And maximum shear force, which is negative in sign, or maximum negative shear force, you can write, it is going to be 50 into minus 0.3, because 0.3 is negative. That is 15 kilonewtons, minus 15 you can write, or 15 kilonewton. So these are the positive and negative values of shear forces based on the sign convention. Okay, that is from here only. The same thing separately, again they're writing and they're calling it maximum. They're calling it as minimum. After this, we'll go to what? This is shear force. Next, last step is your bending moment. So, ILD for bending moment. ILD for bending moment. Right? So, when you're calculating ILD for bending moment, what is the bending moment equation? Bending moment at C is given by what? AB by L. WAB by L, W is 1. Okay. So ILD value of coordinate I have to pick and I have to write. So based on this, A value is 3, B value is 7, L value is 10. What is this value now? 21 divided by 10 makes it 2.1 kilonewton meter. Correct? For a unit load, it is going to be 2.1 kilonewton meter. Now based on this, if I want to calculate the bending moment at C, okay, it is going to be load into the load into AB by L. So load value is 50 into AB by L value is 2.1. How much is this?
105.
There was some network issue. I think I lost the network in between. My video has got stuck, is it? No. Fine. 105. You can write this 2.1 kilonewton meter as the bending moment value in the ideal. Okay, that is for unit load, it is 2.1. And this is the bending moment at C for our given case of 50 kilonewton. Right? So 105 is your bending moment at C. Now after this, we have to calculate that absolute maximum bending moment. Right? So next step, absolute maximum bending moment would be how? It would be got at when the load is at center. In case of a simply supported beam, absolute maximum bending moment will occur when the load is at center. Therefore, when your load is at center, what happens to A and B? A value will be 5, B value will be 5, because our total span is 10. Correct? Therefore, AB by L would be 5 into 5 by 10. That is 2.5 kilonewton meter. Right? Therefore, the absolute bending moment at C, okay, with the central point load is load into AB by L. That is load is 50 into AB by L is 2.5. This may, how much is this?
125
kilonewton meter. This is the absolute bending moment. Initially, I got 105. 105 bending moment diagram ne hakila. This is the bending moment diagram. At 3, here it is 3, here it is 7. The diagram is visible. Okay, I'll do it here. This is beam and cauldron. 3 andre idu. This is 0, this is 3, and this is 10. So this is 3 meter, this is 7 meter. You got a bending moment diagram like this, with this to be 105 kilonewton meter, right? At absolute bending moment, when we are dealing with, this is your beam, and at a distance of 5 meter, at the exactly at the center, your bending moment diagram is going to be like this. This is 125 kilonewton meter. Okay, so this is these two are the numericals related to only related to simply supported beam with point load. Okay, any doubts with these two?
No, ma'am.
Any doubts? Okay. Quickly, if you want to tell how is the procedure, what you will do first, you will find RA and RB based on ILD, right? So to draw that ILD, you will take moments at equal to, you will apply the unit load and you will take moment at each one supports and get the equation and substitute x equal to 0, x equal to the given value and x equal to L. And get the values and plot the RARB diagram. After that, you have to go for shear force diagram, wherein you have to plot the shear force. It will be like this. So at a particular range, so you will know the ordinates here. Based on that, calculate the shear force. Whenever we are calculating reaction or the ordinate, shear force or the bending moment, formula is the external load into the value of the ordinate. Ordinate andre y value. This the value of the influence line diagram. Similarly, we'll do for shear force. Once you draw the shear force, you will calculate the maximum positive and maximum negative shear force. This is nothing but your ordinate value into the load, positive value, and the negative ordinate value into the given load will give you the negative shear force. After that, you will go for bending moment. In bending moment, for a simply supported beam with a point load, it is AB by L. So first calculate AB by L with a given case. And that would be the bending moment at C. After that, calculate for maximum bending moment or absolute bending moment, where A equal to B equal to L by 2. Correct? Half of that. Both are going to be equal. So for this, you calculate the bending moment and that ends the numerical. Clear? So this is drawing the shear force and bending moment diagram, or finding the shear force and bending moment values based on your given diagram. Okay, IID. From the IID, we have to do this. Clear? Any doubts with this?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Quickly, you all can enter your USNs in the chat box. You all can quit the meeting if you have given your attendance.
हेलो मैम,
यस सूरज हेड रोहित, सॉरी नो, हु इज टॉकिंग?
सूरज मैम,
सूरज हेड सूरज
मैम, ಅದು ಆರ್ ಎ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆರ್ ಎ ಮತ್ತೆ ಆರ್ ಬಿ ಕಂಡು ಹಿಡಿತೀವಿ ಅಲ್ರಿ?
ಹಾಂ ರೀ.
ಆ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಸಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಫ್ ಎಫ್ ಐ ಅಂತ ತಗೊಂಡು ಮಾಡಕ್ ಬಂದ್ರಿ?
ಅದು ಅದು ಒಂದು ಮೆಥಡ್ ಐತಿ. ನಾವು ಜನರಲಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಎಂ ಡಿ ಬಿ ಎಂ ಡಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಹಂಗ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಲ್ಲ.
ಹಾಂ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.
ಬಟ್ ಇದೇನು ಗೆಟ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ ಎ ಆರ್ ಬಿ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಐ ಎಲ್ ಡಿ.
ಹಾಂ ಎಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.
ಸೊ ಐ ಎಲ್ ಡಿ ಇಂದ ಮಾಡಿ ತೋರಿಸ್ಬೇಕು ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ. ಇನ್ಫ್ಲುಯೆನ್ಸ್ ಲೈನ್ ಡೈಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಡ್ರಾ ಮಾಡಿ ಮೇನ್ ಅದು ಆರ್ಡಿನೇಟ್ ಸಿಕ್ತದಲ್ಲ ನಮಗೆ, ಆ ಆರ್ಡಿನೇಟ್ ತಪ್ಪು ಸಿಕ್ಕಿತ್ತಂದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ದು ಆರ್ ಎ ಆರ್ ವಿ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ರಾಂಗ್ ಬರ್ತೈತಿ. ಸೊ ಆ ಆರ್ಡಿನೇಟ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ಸಿಕ್ತೈತಿ? ಐ ಎಲ್ ಡಿ ಇನ್ಫ್ಲುಯೆನ್ಸ್ ಲೈನ್ ಡೈಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಡ್ರಾ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಐ ಎಲ್ ಡಿ ಅದು ಆರ್ಡಿನೇಟ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಸಿಕ್ತೈತಿ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ ಎ ಆರ್ ಬಿ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಇನ್ಫ್ಲುಯೆನ್ಸ್ ಲೈನ್ ಡೈಗ್ರಾಮ್. ಎರಡು ಸೇಮ್ ಅವು. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳಿದೆ, ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋರಿ ನೀವು, ನಿಮಗೆ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ ಗೊತ್ತಿರ್ತಾವಲ್ಲ, ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳಕ್ ಈಸಿ ಐತಿ. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ನಿಮಗೆ ಎಫ್ ಐ ಎಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ತಗೊಂಡ್ ಗೊತ್ತೈತಿ. ಬಟ್ ಅದನ್ನ ಹಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಿಟ್ರೆ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಸಿಗಂಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಇನ್ಫ್ಲುಯೆನ್ಸ್ ಲೈನ್ ಡೈಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಇಂದ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು.
ಯೆಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.
ಓಕೆ,
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು,
ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್.